of Xanadu, and I'm just so excited that the weather is perfect tonight. You guys are really lucky out here. It has been like 90, 95 degrees in the park, and you get like 76 and partly cloudy. Maybe mostly cloudy. But I really enjoy this, and I know our performers will. It is fabulous out tonight. My name is Lauren London. I'm the producer of this show, and I couldn't be prouder to present it to you. I have a few thank yous that we need to get out of the way first, and very importantly, the Michigan Council for Arts and Cultural Affairs and the National Endowment for the Arts have provided us with an operational support grant that makes our entire existence possible, so hooray for them. Also, we have two season sponsors we'd like to thank, and those are the law firm of Dykema and Edwards Plumbing and Heating, so thanks to them as well. And our greatest thanks, of course, goes to our donors. We are a nonprofit and donor-funded organization. We have several donors in our audience this evening, so thank you! We really appreciate it. If the rain gets bad enough so that we need to stop the show, that will be the stage manager's call, and we will send you all home. However, you will be welcome back, of course, tomorrow at our final performance of Xanadu. Usually we say, you know, at every subsequent performance, tomorrow's our last show. So if we do get rained out tonight, please join us tomorrow for our final show. This show is a quick 80 minutes long. There is no intermission. There are two bathrooms that are located right behind the band shell, right there down that path. And with that, everyone silence your cell phones and let's enjoy Xanadu!
Oh, hi guys. Didn't even know you were here. A whole bunch of you, even like a crowd. But how much do I love it when that happens, right? Like when ordinary people walking along the California beach in Venice here just stop to look at an ordinary chalk mural on the wall. Like for me, that's what art is. Just goes to show, art isn't for the well-educated or the intelligent, but the people like you. I call this piece the Ancient Greek Arty Chicks. I did a ton of research. I took a book out of the library and everything. The girl in the middle isn't quite right. Never mind. The point is, you are all here to take part in an artistic experience. Ow! Blonde up front and center. All wrong. I ruin everything I do. I'll never get it right. Never, never. Oh, hell. Guys like me shouldn't dream anyway.
Is this really me?
bio.
There is an artist who needs our inspiration to achieve truly great work. For whenever a mortal has a creative instinct, he soon after has a feeling of doubt.
True that, Sister Clio.
Word. And with our guidance, perhaps this artist shall create the greatest art of all. Stars are aligned, are they not? Is this not Venice? Is this not the dawn of the 80s?
Yes, a sweet sister. Meant to bring that up. This is not Venice, Italy. This is Venice, California. And this is not 1780. This is 1980.
Damn.
So in terms of art, we are so going to have our work cut out for us.
As truly as we are the offspring of Zeus, I tell you that I will help this Sonny Malone in his quest for artistic achievement.
But you know the rules, Clio. An artist must never find out he was inspired by a muse. Otherwise, how could there be an artist's ego?
Right you are. To pronounce one's muses is as forbidden as creating art or loving a mortal.
Loving a mortal? Ha 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 ha! Good one.
But what can you do to remain unnoticed?
I shall go in disguise.
Disguise? Tell us more of this disguise.
First, I will not call myself Clio. I will call myself Kira.
You've thrown them off the track now.
Secondly, I will wear roller skates and leg warmers.
You shall be as current as today's headlines.
And thirdly, I will sport an Australian accent. Good night, Mike.
Whoa, it's Clio. Plagiarizing Don McLean. All right, I'll keep it simple. Here was an artist who tried and failed. That ought to make them cry. The jive turkeys. All right, here goes.
Goodbye, what are you doing on the edge of the Santa Monica Pier?
Please leave me alone.
You're angry and you're hurt because you doubt your own artistic abilities.
Why do artists always hate their own work before they've ever even finished it?
Saves time.
Wait a minute, don't I know you from somewhere?
Sydney, Melbourne, the Outback.
Never been there.
They call me Kira, which is good because that's my name. Sonny Malone, oh, I believe in you, even if I'm the only one in the world. Come take my hand.
Snap it!
sisters.
Huzzah to Clio, leader of the muses.
As I am being pursued by the mortal named Sunny Malone, my intercourse with you must be fleeting.
Yes, my younger and exceedingly immature sister. I've noticed that your labors with this human are more than ardent. Are you falling in love with him, or do you simply wish to create art yourself?
You speak with a serpent's tongue, my old, old, ancient, and potentially senile sister. I know that for muses to create is forbidden by Zeus himself, forbidden almost as much as loving a mortal. My work with the one they call Sunny Malone is purely selfish, for Zeus has come to me in a dream and told me that one day soon I shall inspire a work so wondrous that I shall be granted the gift of Xanadu.
Xanadu? The gift so grand that none of us truly knows what it is?
Zeus tells me that he will be sending a sign. And so, off I go to inspire great work. It is a peculiar thing about these mortals. They all know they are going to die, they are determined to create something. The human spirit, it is termed. It gives me great feelings of... Oh, Arato, what is the word for which I search? You know, when there's something so grand and so earnest, yet ultimately so preposterous that one has to laugh. What does one call that?
Andrew Lloyd Webber.
There we are. The human spirit gives me great feelings of Andrew Lloyd Webber. Ah, well, the one named Sunny Malone approaches. Away I fly.
Sweet sisters of inspiration,
let us attend to our various charges.
Calliope! Calliope, hasten hither! Calliope!
I'm already hither!
I crave a word with you. I need not tell you that as firstborn, I was entitled to the position of leader of the muses.
And yet Zeus did not grant you thusly. What gives?
Well, I did lay down with Achilles.
The river god?
He was a river god.
And he a rambling man? And he my baby daddy! He left me with four daughters, Mulpi, Agalope, Piasono, and Felxipaia.
Like a Jennifer or a Susan would have killed you?
My daughters, for years I instructed them in the lutes and the flutes, and now they sit by the seaside singing and luring sailors to their rocky deaths. Ah, yes, my daughters, the sirens.
The sirens?
They never call.
And Zeus did not grant you the leader position because he felt you would be too busy with your children. So he gave the role to Clio.
Well, apparently there's no success, not joy, for you nor I. And now Clio's to be granted Xanadu. Oh, would that I were a god, I would smite her!
Oh, sister, sister, you are goaded with the expression I'm looking for. You're a
evil woman! Evil woman! Evil woman! Evil woman! Run in from another town, hits and goes.
Hey, 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 hey! All my daughters are in charge! Join your mother and aunt and me!
that this is the background to the mural. I've been painting it. I've never even seen it before. Just like the face of that girl that turned out to be Kira. Who am I talking to?
Oh, wow, it's you. Hi.
It's me. Hi.
Well, this place is amazing. This could be the perfect place to open up my apex of all the arts, my roller disco. But what to call it?
How about Sunny's Flies?
Righteous. Let's chill out. I think I see an old marquee in the bushes here.
What's it say?
It says, Kira, the name on the sign is the X Anadu.
Xanadu. I know Xanadu. Sunny, that sign is a sign.
Of course it is, silly.
Right. I'm just being silly. But Xanadu.
Kira, I know we only just met, but I think you're the best thing that's ever happened to me.
Thank you. And you're probably right.
I wonder who owns this old white elephant. Hold on, there's a sign on the door. I wonder how to get a hold of him.
If only there were a book, a magic book, that listed all the locations in Los Angeles and had their phone numbers next to it.
Yeah.
And if that book had pages the color of amber.
I know, I'll look it up in the phone book.
My God, so brilliant.
It's ringing.
She walked in and I'm suddenly a hero. Taking my hopes begin to rise.
Look at me. Can't you tell? Happy to see.
You make it seem I'm so close to my dream, and then suddenly it's all there. The wheels of emotion. I don't need the answer to my heart. I'm ready to say all my
questions. Hi, my name is Sunny Malone, and I'd like to talk to you about renting this large auditorium for an event I'm planning. Yeah, I can be there in 5 minutes. Where are you? It's taking long.
Send in the next appointment a Sonny Malone and Associates. McGuire here. Yeah, I will destroy you! Have a nice day. Oh, you must be Sonny Malone. Where's your associate?
She'll be here in a minute.
You know, last time I saw a guy dressed like you, he tried to sell me a nickel bag. Huh. I still don't know what a nickel bag is. That's the warm-hearted chit-chat part of this conversation. Why are you here?
I'd like to talk to you about renting one of your spaces.
Be more specific. I have a lot of buildings here in Greater Los Angeles.
I'd like to talk to you about a space you own down in Fairfax.
Oh, I'm tearing that block down, putting up condos.
Oh, there's a theater there. It's called the Xanadu.
Xanadu? What do you want with that old fire trap? You gonna show movies?
Yeah, movies, live theater performances. There'll be an art gallery.
Oh, visionary. We developers love the arts.
Really?
Sure, nothing turns a crap neighborhood around like the arts. And then we kick out the artists and sell it for more to the urban professionals.
Well, there's also going to be an athletic element to this endeavor. We would like to open a roller
skate. You wore roller skates to a business meeting. Yeah, either you're an idiot or a genius. How much money you got
to
spend?
I was thinking you'd give it to me for free.
You're an idiot. Me, give you one of my buildings for free.
It would have all of the arts in one
space. Hey, say that free part again, because that's comedy in a bag.
Besides,
right
you're
there.
You're not using it, and it shouldn't be torn down. It's a great old auditorium.
I should know. I built it.
Really?
Yeah, first building I ever built, but never opened it.
You mean that theater's been there all this time, and you've never even opened it? Well, why don't you...
Why don't you stop talking, and I don't throw something at you? I have people on telephones to yell at.
How's it going, Mike?
Kitty, you're back. I knew you'd return.
Sorry?
No, I'm sorry. You remind me of somebody I knew a long time ago when I was young, like this guy. Only I didn't show so much leg. Why do you look familiar?
They call me Kira.
Which is good, because it's her name.
I'm sorry, you remind me of somebody I knew a long time ago. Get out of here, both of you! And forget the Xanadu! I'm tearing that place down! No other face could take you off my mind. You're so refined and much too kind. I've got to warn you, I'm never gonna set you free. 'Cause I was born to love you for eternity. Whenever you're away from me, wherever you go, you're never far away from me. I want you to know, I only have to close my eyes, dear, and suddenly I'm where you are. You better never stray, 'cause I'll never be far away.
Suddenly I'm where you are.
Grecian, that pretty young Southern Belle's all the way from Alabama.
Sure enough, and sure as you're born, you blow my way, daddy-o.
And feature this theater I've built just for you. What should we label it?
How about the Zanny?
Kill me, kill me! How's about this clarinet player laying down that last spin on construction?
Had you ever afford such an expensive theater on the dough you get for playing that liquor still?
Know that song I wrote about you? The Duke says it's solid gold.
But do you really think I'm a sophisticated lady?
None other, Duchess. None other.
And that's the first song I want to hear when we open this place. Once you build this theater, they're going to be big band concerts in here. Oh, the joint will be jumping with jitterbugs.
I've been looking at the books. I don't think we should open just yet.
What?
Ah, time's not right. You know, we're fighting the Japanese and the Germans. Times is tough. You gotta be tights with your bread.
And you think just because there are two wars and a depression that it's not time for art? So you don't want to open the theater till times are better because it'll probably lose money now?
Bingo, you did!
Oh, I did. And I hope you do. But I have to leave you, Danny.
I don't get you.
I'm going to leave you.
Oh, you'll come back.
No, I won't come back to you. And 35 years from now, when a young man comes to your door and asks you to rent this theater, you will put aside your greed and help him.
You did not say that when we broke up.
But I'm saying it now during this flashback. If you ever love me, give the kid a break.
But
the path back to me is in that theater. You better never stray, 'cause I'll never.
Like that.
She's
one foxy lady.
Say, how old would you say she is? 24, 25, 60?
I'd say somewhere in there. Dude, what is your case?
My case. My case. I'll tell you what my case is. This idea you had, that both of you had, it was her idea too, wasn't it, to do concerts in this theater?
Well, sure, it's not just
See, you're just annoying me. Why do you keep talking? I had that idea too, to do concerts here. Classy stuff, swing music, and three girls singing in tight, tight harmony.
Anybody feeling cold? No one there.
kind of music went out with running board. I'm talking about electric guitar.
Rock and roll,
sundown, I'll give you and the girl 25%.
But that's near impossible.
Yeah, I knew you didn't have it in you.
Well, just because it's impossible doesn't mean I'm not going to do it. Just means it's going to take a while.
Look at you thinking you're all fancy, swinging from the rafters, making this place over like a regular old Errol Flynn.
I don't know who that is.
Oh, you don't know who that is. All right, listen, Bright Eyes. You got till sundown, and it's a deal.
Kira!
Sonny, what is it?
The owner says that if we fix this place up by this afternoon, he'll give us a quarter of it.
By this afternoon? And for a quarter of it?
Isn't it great?
It's a terrible deal, and the task is impossible.
Oh, Kira, this is my chance to create something. Oh, this is happening. This is so happening. I am so on the verge. My career as an artist is finally happening. I feel I am on the brink of total artistic fulfillment. I could use a fresco.
Now you've got male enthusiastic. Why, Mr. Fraser Joey?
Come on, let's draw plans of what this place is going to look like. You draw too.
Oh, I really am not allowed to. I can't do the drawings. There's strict rules against that.
See, here, draw a lobby for me.
Oh, I'm terrible.
Here, draw.
It's awful.
You don't need to be so hard on yourself.
No, it's awful. But I did it. And it's there. Maybe for all time. Maybe for a long time. Maybe for a short time. But it's there. And no wonder they are dealing with mortality, delight, so in creation. I envy you, your kind.
God, you're not such a bad drawer.
You. I think you're wonderful. Now, sister?
Now, sister. You're sailing softly through the sun in a broken stone age dawn. You fly so high.
Yeah. There's no time left. No time at all.
What, restore theater in an hour? Sure, I can do that.
Crikey, you're unstoppable, you are. All this positive outlook, soon you won't need me at all.
Woman, don't harsh my mellow. Come on, let's get to work.
But there's no way to accomplish this restoration in the time allotted, not even with the help of my four sisters. Not even with the help of my four sisters.
Oh,
just happened by.
Sisters?
Ah, yes, my sisters. And this is only some of them. Sonny, meet Tapsicore. Oh, she's a regular dancing fool. This is your Tabby. She always has a song in her heart. This is Thalia. She loves comedy. And this is Arato. She's always making up rhymes and lyrics.
What rhymes with Nantucket?
Music and lyrics, dancing, and a funny story. Our father always said, put them together and you get a musical comedy. And even with the help of these most powerful sisters, the task is impossible.
Not possible? Not for Sonny Malone. Stick with me, little ladies. One, two, three, four!
Make this theater over and me too, but just... Sonny Malone, right?
Right, Sonny Malone.
Danny McGuire. Malone and McGuire, like an old vaudeville team.
I don't get that joke. Why'd you give up on this place?
Let me tell you, I fell in love with a girl. A remarkable girl. She inspired me, brought out the best in me, but I wanted to make money. So I gave up on my dreams, and before you knew it, the guy I was gone, and the girl was gone, too.
Annie. Enough about your personal life. Come on, I said I'd fix this place up, and I did!
Yes, you did, partner.
All right. But I warn you, I don't know the first thing about being a partner.
Oh, it's easy. You work together and argue a lot. It's kind of like being married, without the good part.
That's just wrong.
What do you say? Is it a deal?
It's a deal.
What do you know? I'm back in the show business.
In Dingadeer did Kubla Khan a stately pleasure down decree.
Where Alf the sacred river ran through caverns measureless to man, down to a sacred sea. Kitty, it is you!
My name is Kira.
Kira? Sure, if you were a kitty, you'd have to be much, much... You'd be my age. Unless...
Unless?
Never mind, hey. If you see a girl who looks a lot like you, only she's my age and southern and goes by the name of Kitty, would you tell her I loved her and I was a fool and I never fell in love again?
Well, that would be a lot for me to say to someone I just met. But I'm sure wherever she is, she knows it.
Oh, I should see how that sign looks from the back of the house.
Kira, this is all because of you. Can't you feel it?
My gosh, I feel so many things right now. Most of them delightful. A few actually humiliating. But the majority delightful.
Don't you feel the joy and, you know, the relief that comes with creativity?
I feel... Chest, a warm feeling, not unlike cognac. Something wonderful and exciting. Oh, but something forbidden. Something I feel will bring my destruction.
You're so Catholic.
Oh, I have a sense of foreboding something terrible.
Hey, come on, Sonny boy, you gotta see this sign from back here.
Sign?
The Xanadu!
The Xanadu?
The Xanadu sign.
The Xanadu sign?
People see that sign and just die!
They'll love it!
People die, love the Xanadu sign!
Hey, come on!
Sonny, why don't you run back with Danny? I'll just stay here and do some less in the details. Go!
The sign is so clear, anybody can see it!
Goodbye, Mike.
Flyo.
Oh, it is you, Hermes, the fleet-footed messenger of the gods. What brings you to me, Hermes?
I come with a message from Zeus.
Yes, Hermes.
He wishes to know if you have seen his sign.
Yes, I have seen his sign.
He also wishes to remind you that the penalty for creating art on one's own is eternal damnation in the netherworld. World.
I am aware of that. You may tell Zeus.
He thirdly wishes to remind you that the penalty for loving a mortal is eternal damnation in the netherworld.
Why does Zeus tell me these things? I love no one and I have created nothing. I am an ageless and loveless, uncreated being. Why does Zeus accuse me so, Hermes? Why, Hermes, why?
Bitch! I don't know your life.
Zeus, I hear your warnings. And so run I must, away from this Sonny Malone who has stolen my heart.
Oh my. You would have to be blind not to see this sign just staring you in the face.
Sonny, please stop talking. It hurts.
Kira, don't be a bummer.
Sadly, bummer I am, and bummer I shall be. Sonny, it is here that I must take my leave of you.
Leave of me like
leave me?
I must go.
But you can't go. The Xanadu say I need you here.
You can do this without me, surely. Even the Xanadu Club is open and thriving. You shall pause a moment and reflect on us. And I'll know wherever I am, they will always have this roller disco.
Sure. But I need you here just to be here.
Stuff and nonsense. I have met you only a moment earlier. We do not know one another well enough to have any significant ties. Do we?
You know, I guess you're right. Don't walk away.
So do I. Why do you speak in that semi-intimate manner?
I must say, don't walk away. You'll be the way you were before, when you don't want me anymore. Don't turn around, don't ever leave. A lonely room where empty days are gathering to meet me when you're gone, gone. How in the world will I? All you gotta do is stay.
Don't walk away.
All you gotta do is stay.
Don't walk away.
Hey, hey, hey.
Now, Penny, all is lost. Clio, the size of the Australian Kira, is not in love with the mortal at all. She is running away from him.
Fool and blind one. She runs from the mortal because she is in love with him. This has worked beyond my wildest dreams.
Kira!
Sorry, no, I must go.
Stop, wait.
No, this is forbidden. I must fly. Fly like the wind.
Don't walk away.
Don't walk away.
Don't say goodbye.
Don't say goodbye.
Walk away.
should have known I'd find you on the beach. Here's your skate.
Oh, Sunny, Sunny, I'm afraid that I am in love with you, and now I must go away for all eternity.
Wow, you are so complicated. The truth of it is I'm in love with you.
No, no, can I hear these words? Each web of flowers in my ear is a dagger in my heart.
Oh, go ahead. Tell her a little more, Sunny.
Let us all share a secret. It shall prove most amusing. You first, Calliope.
I'm not wearing a bra.
Scandalous! Who's next? Shall we start with your name, Kira?
Sunny, I must tell you, my name is not Kira.
Oh. You know, that was actually the one thing I didn't like about you.
My name is Clio.
Oh. That's pretty.
Oh, wait, it gets better.
Continue to share, Sister Clio.
Sonny, my name is Clio, and I'm not a Catholic. I'm not a Scientologist. I'm not even Australian. See, this is how I usually talk.
What is this? Who are you?
Sonny, I am a muse. Do you know what a muse is?
Isn't that like a little alley with quaint townhomes?
No. That's M-E-W-S. This is M-U-S-E. Muse. A muse inspires an artist.
You have inspired me. You are my muse.
All cards on the table now, Clio.
All right. In the modern mortal age in which you dwell, the word muse has taken on a metaphorical sense as a person who inspires another person. I am not that. In ancient Greece, the father of the gods, Zeus, did lay down with the keeper of memory, Mnemosyne, on 9 consecutive nights, and he sired 9 daughters.
So, what are you saying?
She's saying she's a demigod, bonehead.
It's so obvious. Am I the only one here who gets it?
Kira, I don't believe what you say.
But you love me.
I love you. I don't believe you.
I am confused by the ways of mortals. How can love exist when there is not trust? I'm telling you now that I am a muse.
I'm telling you. Schizophrenia is nothing to be ashamed of.
Wait, it gets even darker. Malkemini and I...
Muse of tragedy.
Muse of epics.
We were so jealous of our sister.
So we whimsically placed a curse on the two of you.
What? To fall in love.
So what are you saying?
You were never really in love in the first place.
A curse? But it feels so real. Sunny, don't believe them. I know that I am in love with you. I know this, for it is verity itself.
Actually, that curse part makes a lot of sense.
What?
You know, we did fall in love pretty fast.
So, afford me a moment of clarity. You don't believe that I'm a muse, but you do believe that my sister's placed a curse on you?
What? That one on the right looks seriously witchy-poo.
I try to dress simply and let my personality be the star.
But this is real, genuine love.
Can you prove it?
Well, no.
There. See?
Oh, fie upon you, Sunny Malone.
Fie!
Yeah, fie!
Sunny Malone, you are such a fool, I can no longer use words to express it.
I tell him!
Tell him in a song!
I pity the fool.
I want you to know you're a user. I'll really down.
forever there granting encouragement and doing backup. I must confess to you that I have done that which Zeus has decreed as forbidden. I have declared my very museness to a mortal.
No!
I have also allowed myself to fall in love with this mortal.
Never!
I have also, in my most blatant defiance of Zeus, created art myself and enjoyed it.
Oh, no, you didn't!
All right, now I've had it. This is cute, this whole cult thing you've got going on. But seriously, I don't believe any of you are from ancient Greece.
Dude, we speak in unison. How much proof do you need?
He believes not. Away I go. I shall return from whence I've come, back into the chalk mural that is crude and amateurish.
Hey!
Once in this drawing, Pegasus shall fly me to Mount Olympus, where Zeus shall rightly punish me.
Then we shall leave also. We shall return to the mural. Let this year, the year 1980, be known as the year all inspiration left the arts.
And we shall leave as well, smug in our confidence.
Why, you men, Kira, Clio, everybody thought we had something there, man.
I see the early glow, I hear you say hello, I watch the shadows fall, I don't see you at all.
It's a
I hear you say goodbye. I see a tear in your eye.
Think of what might have been. As long as that mural is there, I'll still have some hope.
No!
Sonny Malone, I have something to tell you, and know that it comes from a place of the heart. I screwed you over.
Okay.
And I know you're going to want to resort to violence, so I've consulted with my attorneys, and they have told me, wait a minute, did you just say, okay. Kira, the girl who was my inspiration, turns out she's crazy.
Most people working in creative, it's 50-50.
No life is certifiable. She said she's a muse from Mount Olympus. She said she came out of a drawing that I did, and now she's gone back. She's currently waiting for Pegasus to fly her to Mount Olympus.
A muse! That explains why I knew her so long ago and she never seems to age. Maybe my life is taking some extreme spiritual turn. That happens to rich people sometimes. Not often.
She's crazy. She said she loved me.
She said she loved you. You and not me. Well, she is crazy. This is nonsense. We need to forget this absurdity and get on with our lives. Consequences!
Zeus, my lord, father of all gods,
master of the universe and holder of all lightning.
Oh.
I am Thetis. I'm a goddess of the sea, and I know things.
Ooh.
I look into the eyes of this child and know that it is not a curse, but actual love.
I know this as well, but my only evidences are my feelings. These very feelings which torture me so painfully.
She's got bad, and that ain't good.
I shall now declare my sentence. Eternal banishment in the netherworld.
Stay your hand, my lord.
Ooh.
I shall present evidence of genuine love, which can be proven not with feelings. With hard evidence.
What?
How?
Impossible.
She proves this.
She's good.
Zeus, I remind you of my son, Achilles, the greatest warrior of Greece, and how he was destroyed by Paris, who shot his arrow straight through Achilles' heel, thus killing him. For, as you know, dear Zeus, all the gods' offspring are dipped into the river Styx, thus making them impervious to injury. But they are held by their ankles, so their only vulnerable spot is their ankles.
I do recall this.
Master Zeus! I appeal to you. Look at the attire Clio has donned. The woolen woven fabric she has placed around her ankles.
The leg warmers. But of course, no curse can penetrate this demigoddess. Not as long as these mighty leg warmers are on my ankles.
Oh, if I had only thought to need leg warmers for my brave son Achilles.
Then it is true. Love has triumphed. Clio truly did fall in love with that mortal.
I don't care. She'll be punished anyway.
But my Zeus, oh my mighty, mighty Zeus, this was your heart, not your brain.
Love you.
What a swell guy. And love. level with me, Clio? Are the big hands and big feet telling me the story I want to hear?
Who is this foolish mortal? He's not allowed in the world of the gods.
Sonny, do you not know where you are? This is Mount Olympus, where the gods dwell. This is Zeus and three attending goddesses.
Yeah, I saw this movie. This is Clash of the Titans.
No, it is not.
Yes, it is. You're all actors slumming for bucks in some Harryhausen film. Yeah, you're Ursula Andress, and you're Claire Bloom, and you're Laurence Olivier, like, out for a dollar.
Infidel!
And you, you're two-time Academy Award winner Maggie Smith!
Assassin! Assassin!
I'll fight these bunch of hams for you any day.
Sonny, no. These are actual gods.
But this is just like the movie.
If they resemble the actors who portray them in a film that you saw, it's merely a testament to the craft of filmmaking.
These are actual gods?
We are gods, and we are not amused.
I don't care. I will fight anyone or anything to be with the woman I love.
You would fight Zeus for love. You would fight me.
Yes, no. I would. I love her that much.
Oh. Yeah. I've never seen that before. You really love her that much? And Kyle, do you love this mortal?
With all my heart.
Oh, and you would give up all your powers, including immortality?
Kira.
I would.
Kyle, honey, this is the 1980s. The muses are in retreat. Creativity will be stymied for decades. The theater, they'll just take some stinkeroo movie or some songwriter's catalog, throw it on stage, and call it a show.
Then I shall take the improbably popular art forms in each moment of time, the stage adaptation of the inferior cinematic offering, the music of the box that is to... And I shall use them to remind mankind that there's more than wealth or fame, and that is the human experience rendered comprehensible through art.
Oh, I love her so much.
I begin this quest on Earth today with a roller disco.
So be it. Clio, you shall live on Earth as a mortal and as an Australian.
Thanks, Mike.
But... before you go, one final gift.
No! I know, tragedy is so close to the end.
Mighty Zeus, king of the world, keeper of the clouds, no more further gifts, I implore you. Clio's gotten what she deserves, to live and die in LA. Let anyone who hears of the quest for Xanadu how it is epic and a tragedy.
Be on with you! The quest for Xanadu shall end quickly and be happy!
Quick and happy?
Uh-huh.
I am outraged, and Calliope would be outraged as well if it weren't for the constraints of cast doubling.
Kira, I don't have a lot to offer you. Just, I love you. And you can create whatever you want to.
Oh, my epic mortal. That is the greatest gift of all. To create art and to love someone? That is Xanadu.
That is Xanadu. Before for the Zeus. And thank you for the greatest gift of all. The Xanadu. A place where nobody dares to go. The love we can.
We are in Xanadu.
Somewhere.
Thank you.